Now, in the first model, when you are talking about the actual start of the disaster part, so before that, you should be able to know the basic concepts and the basic terminologies that are used in disaster management, the basic meanings, the basic definitions. Okay, so that you should be able to know because those words will be used frequently throughout the syllabus. Okay, so that you should know. So here is one PPT from Asian Disaster Preparedness Center, very good PPT, where they have very nicely shown about the various words, the meanings of the various words is described very nicely. Okay, so that we will see in today's lecture. So, basic definitions and terms. So from this lecture, what is the objective is at the end of this session, you should be able to define disaster, hazard, risk, elements at risk, vulnerability, capacity, response, relief, rehabilitation, reconstruction, development, mitigation, preparedness, and prevention. So when these words are used anywhere in the syllabus from here on, you will be able to define that. You will be able to tell the meaning of that particular word. Okay, so that will be covered in this PPT. So now what do you see here? Just a mountain and a stone rolling through the mountain, correct? Now, if you are standing or someone is standing at the bottom of that mountain, so there is the possibility of happening of disaster if the stone rolls and falls on the person, correct? So it is going to cause damage to his life. Okay, so related to this phenomenon only, we will see the further terminologies. Now, what is hazard? Like we have seen in the previous lectures also, phenomenon or situation which has the potential to cause disruption or damage to the people, their property, their services, and their environment. There is potential for occurrence of an event. So if this stone is going to roll down and if someone is standing here or if the houses are there at the bottom, so the rolling of this stone is the hazard. There is a possibility that this particular event, that is the rolling of the stone, is going to cause the loss of life, the loss of property. Okay. Then what is disaster? The serious disruption of the functioning of the society, causing widespread human, material, or environmental losses, which exceed the ability of the affected people to cope using their own resources. Okay, now it's not necessary that whenever you get in the defined question in the paper, you are supposed to write each and every word same. You can write the meaning of it what you know, but all these things should be covered in that definition. Okay, in the definition that you yourself will be writing, of course that is very good, not mugging up and writing the same thing that you have read somewhere rather than making your own definition. That is actually good, but then you sh it should covered all the elements, right? If you just write the what do you say, the disruption or loss of life, just if you write the loss of life, that's not the only thing related to disaster, right? It's loss of life, material or property or environmental losses, everything should come. And then if you do not write this, see, whenever there is some smaller type of disaster, which, you know, now if I say you are going by a bike and there you come across an accident, okay? So it's a small, say it's a very smaller disaster, not a bigger accident, where actually the person himself can ha is having the ability to get up, drive again, and go to the hospital, or nearby few people might help, and then everything will be okay. So that will not be considered as a disaster because you have the capability, the affected person. Even if you have faced an accident, but that is not that bigger accident where you have got a lot of what do you say, a lot of bruises. It's not like that, say. So you are capable enough to get up and drive your own vehicle and go to the hospital or go to your home like that. So that will not consider as a disaster because you have the capability to deal with it. Okay, so that will not consider the disaster. So what is written here? The serious disruption of the functioning of society, causing widespread human, material or environmental losses which exceed the ability of the affected people, the people who are affected in that disaster, okay, which exceed the ability of the affected people to cope using their own resources. Okay, they cannot come out of that disaster. The affected people cannot come out of that disaster by their own. They will be requiring the help from the external people. Okay, so that is called the disaster. Okay, so these words should come whenever you are going to write the definition or meaning of a disaster. Okay, then an event either man-made or natural, sudden or progressive, causing widespread human, material or environmental losses. This is also one of the definition. Okay, along with it, so it could be man-made, natural, sudden, like an earthquake. Progressive, like heavy rainfall continuously flooding throughout the day. Okay, so that causing widespread human, material and environmental losses. Then, now you know what is hazard. Now you know what is disaster. We had seen in the previous lecture also. Then vulnerability also, I have explained you that it is a condition or set of conditions that reduces people's ability to prepare for, withstand or respond to a hazard. Okay, you cannot, the conditions are like that the community is not able to cope with it, to cope with that disaster, to overcome that disaster or be prepared to face that disaster. So that is vulnerability. Okay, you are at a risk, you are more vulnerable. If I am living in an area which is on slope and which is a landslide prone area, I am more vulnerable because the conditions are like that it reduces the, what you say, possibility of dealing with the disaster. Correct. If I am living on the coastal line, okay, very near to the coastal line, it reduces my possibility to deal with the cyclone, with the storm, okay, because I am more vulnerable. The conditions there are more vulnerable, okay, that this disaster will happen and that will reduce my ability to cope with it. Okay, so that is called vulnerability. Then, the same image that we had seen, that is, there was a mountain and a stone rolling through that mountain, through the slope of that mountain. So, see here, the stone rolling through the mountain is the hazard, as I said, unless and until it is going to affect anyone, it is called hazard. If there is no one at the bottom, say, if there is no house, there is no person, nothing, the stone is going to roll, but it is not going to cause any damage. It will just be hazard. Okay, but then there is a person standing here, so he is vulnerable to face that hazard. He does not know. His face is opposite to where the hazard is happening. I mean, he is not aware of that hazard. Okay? He is not aware of that hazard and he is standing at a position where he is more vulnerable to get affected. So, that is called vulnerability. And then, when the hazard happens, and since the person is more vulnerable, it is going to damage the life of that person. So, that is called the disaster then. Okay, then capacity. I told you in the last lecture also, wherever this capacity word comes, it's about the people. Okay, it's about the community. So that is those positive condition or ability which increases a community's ability to deal with the hazard. Okay, it is basically the ability of the community to deal with the hazard. The more the capacity, the more the better thing. Correct. So capacity development, when you say, wherever the word, actually it comes with development word, capacity development. That is developing the community's ability, the people's ability to deal with the hazard. Capacity, where this capacity word came from? It came from capability, capable. Okay, so that is capacity. Okay, so ability to deal with the hazard. Whose ability? People's ability, the community's ability. So whenever we talk about capacity, it is people who will be dealing with that disaster. Okay, then you see the images also, huh? Here, see here, the people, you would see that they are dealing with the disaster, so that becomes capacity. Okay, then risk. See, the probability that a community structure or geographical area is to be damaged or disrupted by the impact of a particular hazard on account of their nature, construction, and proximity to a hazardous area. Now, what happens is, like I told you the same example during vulnerability, if my area or if my house is constructed on a slope and that particular area is a landslide prone area. Okay, now landslide has not happened yet. Okay, landslide has not happened yet. Okay, but I know that if at all there is any landslide here, I will be more affected. Okay, so landslide hasn't happened yet. Then what I will say, I am living in a risky area. Okay, or say if you are living in an area which is earthquake prone area. In the earthquake, we will see how earthquake-prone areas are divided into different zones. So if I say I am living in a earthquake-prone area, okay, so I am living in a risky area, correct? So probability, it is a risky area. That doesn't mean that the disaster is going to confirm happen over there. That doesn't mean that. It might or might not happen. Of course, it is a risky area depending upon the probability of happening the particular disaster there, depending upon the geographical condition, depending upon the construction. Say, I am living in an area in a building which is quite old, which is quite old construction. And of course, then I would say it is a risky building which is prone to earthquake if that earthquake happens in this particular area. So I would say it is a risky area or a risky building. Okay. But then if this particular area is, if there is warning of a disaster happening, okay, then that particular area becomes more vulnerable. It becomes more vulnerable to that particular disaster. Okay, so there is a slight difference between risk and vulnerability. Okay, so risk is the probability that a community's structure or the geographic area is to be damaged, the probability, okay, is to be damaged or disrupted by the impact of a particular hazard on account of their nature, construction, and proximity to a hazardous area. Okay, then see here. When hazard meets vulnerability, as we have seen in the previous lecture also, and where capacity is low, where capacity or people going to affected, say. Okay, so that is equal to the disaster risk. Okay, that is going to lead to the disaster risk. Okay. Then, elements at risk. Now, elements at risk, matlab, the things that are going to get affected. So, people, building, crops, other such like societal components exposed to known hazard, which are likely to be adversely affected by the impact of the hazard. Okay, basically, everything, every component that is exposed. Okay, so they are likely to be adversely affected by the impact of the hazard. So they are called the elements at risk. Okay, then this is your disaster management cycle, which in the previous lecture also we had seen. A more detailed one is disaster. Okay, and after disaster you have response and relief. Okay, after response and relief you have rehabilitation, then reconstruction. development, prevention, mitigation, preparedness, and you are then ready to and prepared for that particular disaster if it happens again. Okay, so this is a disaster management cycle. Okay, the 3 R's: response or relief, rehabilitation, reconstruction. Okay, development, prevention, mitigation, preparedness, and again if that disaster occurs. Okay, cycle. Why we say this? For example, flood. Every year, every monsoon, I know my area is going to be flooded depending on the previous history. Okay, so this cycle follows, correct? Then now what is response? Each and every word we will see shortly. Okay, then when you say when disaster when occurs, so what is the response? The general meaning of the response is also how you react, correct? What do you mean by response? That is how a person reacts to it, acts to it. Okay, so response in terms of the disaster management cycle also means the actions taken immediately. Immediately after the disaster has occurred, the immediate actions that are taken, that is called the response. Okay, so that is actions taken immediately following the impact of a disaster, when exceptional measures are required to meet the basic needs of the survivors. Okay, so that is called the response. Immediate action. The immediate actions mein kya kya aata hai? For example, if there is an earthquake, okay, loss of life, loss of people, property, everything. You will have to provide immediate medical attention. You will have to provide immediate temporary structures for people to live. You will have to provide them food. Okay, those are immediate actions. Okay, and similarly, like here it is given response/relief, so they come under one roof. So what is relief? Measures that are required in search and rescue of the survivors, as well to meet the basic needs for shelter, water, food, health care. So it is similar like response. The response are the immediate actions. So that actions could be anything. Okay, that actions, depending upon the disaster, it could be anything. Okay, say if there is an accident, to help from the people. So that is also a response. Okay, and relief also, that is basically the main thing of relief. Okay, is to search and rescue the survivors. Jaise maine earthquake ka tumko example diya. The first thing to be done is the search and rescue of the survivors. Otherwise, the number of deaths will be more. People facing the death will be a lot more. So the first thing in the earthquake is to be done is search and rescue of the survivors, and then meeting their basic needs like the medical aid, the shelter, the food, the everything. Okay, so that means the response and the relief. So they come under one meaning only, response/relief. Okay, then after this immediate actions, then you have recovery, rehabilitation, and reconstruction written here. See, rehabilitation and reconstruction. Recovery, what I would say, is the combination of all these three things. We will see further. So recovery, rehabilitation, and reconstruction. Now what is that? You have seen response and relief. Now next is, see here, response, relief, or just relief. Here it is written rehabilitation and reconstruction is what comes in the disaster management cycle. Okay, combining these three actions or three phases is called the recovery phase. Okay, in order to come out of that particular disaster, in order to recover from that particular disaster, the whatever steps or phases that are followed, that is called the recovery phase. Okay, and then what are the steps? They are in order to face the upcoming disaster in the next year or in the coming years. Okay, then mitigation, preparedness, prevention, all these measures are the planning done in order to face the disaster in the later years if that occurs. Okay, but this phases, that is relief, rehabilitation, reconstruction, these are recovery phase in order to come out of that particular disaster which has happened now. Okay. So we will see the difference between recovery, rehabilitation, and reconstruction. As I told you, the recovery is the phase combining these three phases, the whole phase of coming back to the original position. Okay. Then recovery. So what is recovery? The process undertaken by a disaster-affected community to fully restore itself to the pre-disaster level of the functioning. So that is recovery. To recover back to its original function, to its normal functioning, how it was before the disaster. Okay, so that is called the recovery. Then, see here a very good example given. There is one chair, okay, and a person sits on it, and the chair breaks. So, temporary, you have, tied the legs and all things, the broken things of the chair, and made it stand. Okay, this is one condition. The other condition is the same chair, the person sits, and the chair gets break. Okay, then you reconstruct the whole chair in such a way, okay, in such a way that now if anyone sits or a person of his own weight sits, it won't break. Okay, so here if you see, it is a temporary structure made, correct? Here in this first image, is a temporary structure made just by tying the legs and whatever the broken things of the chair are and just made it stand there temporarily. Okay, it might not withstand again the same weight, but temporary it is made. Okay, so that anyone else could at least use it. But then if it is completely reconstructed, taking into account that if a person of such a weight sits, it should not break. Okay, so if completely the structure is changed, okay, and reconstructed into a new one, taking into account the further damage that has happened, okay, that is other condition. ओके तो यही मीनिंग है रिहैबिलिटेशन एंड रिकंस्ट्रक्शन का. द फर्स्ट थिंग इज कॉल्ड रिहैबिलिटेशन एंड द सेकेंड थिंग इज कॉल्ड रिकंस्ट्रक्शन. हम लोग वही देख रहे थे ना, रिकवरी हुआ, हमको रिहैबिलिटेशन एंड रिकंस्ट्रक्शन क्या है ये देखने का था. ओके एंड रिहैबिलिटेशन एज यू सी सी रिलीफ, रिहैबिलिटेशन कम्स फर्स्ट एंड देन कम्स रिकंस्ट्रक्शन. क्योंकि जब भी डिजास्टर होता है, ओके एंड इफ यू वांट टू द डैमेज ऑफ द प्रॉपर्टी सो मच दैट यू आर सपोज टू हैव सम टेम्पररी स्ट्रक्चर इन ऑर्डर टू फैसिलिटेट, इन ऑर्डर टू प्रोवाइड ऑल द फैसिलिटीज टू द पीपल. ओके यू शुड, यू मस्ट हैव अ टेम्पररी स्ट्रक्चर फॉर नाउ, फॉर दैट पर्टिकुलर इंस्टेंट व्हेन द डिजास्टर हैज ऑकर्ड. सो दैट इज कॉल्ड रिहैबिलिटेशन. Like for example, simple thing, when an earthquake occurs, of course you cannot make the building in one day. The whole building that is being damaged or the many buildings in that area which are damaged, you cannot construct it in one day. Not even a house could be constructed in one day. So what you do is make temporary tents, temporary structures, okay, in order to provide shelter to those people. That is called rehabilitation. The temporary structure, of course, they are not going to live in those tents for further years also. It is just till the normal phase, the normal living comes. Okay. So till that, the temporary structure that is made, that is called rehabilitation. And further, when the whole construction again starts, again the city is brought back to its own position, again the buildings are raised. Okay, so that is called reconstruction. Okay, so very good example given this by a particular image. The first one is called rehabilitation, temporary structure made in order to support, and the second is called the reconstruction. And now when you know my particular building was in the earthquake prone area, and it is more prone maybe because of the construction, improper construction, or maybe it was too old that it was more prone to earthquake. So next time when the reconstruction would be done in that particular place, it will be done taking into account all those effects that happened to that building. Okay, it will be made more earthquake resistant. Okay, so likewise here, how the chair is made more stronger, taking into account how it broke. So same way, the reconstruction would be done in a better way, taking into account the disaster that happened previously to it. Okay, so the first one is rehabilitation, and the second one is the reconstruction. See, the chair, the disaster, rehabilitation, and here also it is the chair, the disaster, and reconstruction. Okay, then, like given here, actions taken in the aftermath of a disaster to assist the victims to repair their dwellings, to re-establish the essential services, to revive key economic and social activities. Okay, immediate actions that are taken aftermath to disaster, but those are temporary things. Like if you see here, for example, there might be a bridge here or a culvert here, jo collapse ho gaya, and then they have no scope to go to that particular, to cross that particular area, say. Okay, so a temporary structure would be made. Of course, this is not a permanent structure to assist for many years. Okay, so till the time the disaster is overcome, okay, so a temporary structure would be made till the time the main structure taking time. Okay, so this temporary structure would be made, so that is called the rehabilitation. And reconstruction, that is permanent measures. This is not temporary, this is permanent measures to repair or replace the damaged dwellings and the infrastructure and to set the economy back on the course. That is called the reconstruction, the permanent measures to repair all the property that is damaged. Okay. Then development. Now, what is mean by development? Sustained efforts intended to improve or maintain the social and economic well-being of a community. So that is called development. Directly development word when you use. Okay. So you know the meaning. Developing. Okay. So that is sustained efforts intended to improve and maintain the social and economic well-being of a community. There has to be the development of the society, plus there has to be the development of the economic well-being of that society also. So that is called the social and the economic well-being. Okay, so that is called the development. For example, the people who have faced the disaster. Okay, so these are the later phases now, because we have seen relief, response, rehabilitation, reconstruction, and then you have development. Now, for example, after that disaster has occurred, say if you say earthquake itself, okay, so now the people are to be made aware that a small training to be given how to deal with the disaster, and also education should be given, knowledge should be shared on how to, you know, for example, making your medical insurance. There might be people who do not have their insurance. Okay, so they should, because they might not be aware of it, so they might be made aware of the several schemes by bank. They might be, might should be aware of the medical insurance. They should be aware of the money management. Okay, so that it will bring to the economic development of that particular area. Okay, then what is prevention? Measures taken to avert a disaster, to prevent a disaster from occurring if possible. Like here, see, we were talking about this hazard. Now, this person knows, even if I'm standing at the bottom, I am not going to get affected, because this is not going to cause any disaster, because preventive measures are taken. See here, if you see, the preventive measures are taken, the stone cannot fall down through that particular mountain, so I can stand below it. Because I know preventive measures are taken. Just a small example, just to tell you this. Okay, so these are the preventive measures which will prevent a disaster from occurring. Okay, so this is to impede a hazard so that it does not have any harmful effects. Okay, then what is mitigation? Like I told you last time also, mitigation is reduction of the impact of a disaster. So there is a difference between prevention and there is a difference between mitigation. Now, I know that this particular disaster is cannot be avoided. Say this particular hazard cannot be, I mean, disaster hazard cannot be prevented. Hazard cannot be prevented. Say, if at all it affects the life and property, then it becomes a disaster. So if I know that this particular hazard cannot be prevented, it is going to fall and it is going, it might cause a disaster affecting the life and property. So what is in my hands is how I can reduce the impact of that disaster. Okay, so what this person has done, so the person who is there, okay, in that particular place, now he has made a shelter for himself so that even if that disaster occurs, the effect will be less. First of all, when he was not having any shelter and he was not aware of that particular disaster, okay, he was going, I mean, his life was affected. Now what he knows that the disaster is going to happen, I should reduce the impact of the disaster. So he's having a shelter over there so that the impact of the disaster would be reduced. Disaster cannot be prevented. It is not avoided in this situation. It is going to happen, but measures or steps that could be taken prior to that disaster, prior, okay, शेल्टर एक दिन में तो नहीं बना और इमीडिएट एक्शन तो नहीं है. व्हेन यू सी अ रो स्टोन फॉलिंग एंड यू स्टार्टेड मेकिंग अ शेल्टर, इट्स नॉट लाइक दैट, करेक्ट? आई नो दैट, आई मीन दिस पर्सन नोज से दैट ही इज लिविंग इन दिस पर्टिकुलर एरिया वेयर दिस रोलिंग ऑफ द स्टोन्स एंड अफेक्टिंग द लाइफ प्रॉपर्टी, दिस डिजास्टर इज कॉमन. ओके, ही इज अवेयर ऑफ दैट पर्टिकुलर डिजास्टर, सो प्रायर ही विल बी टेकिंग एक्शंस बिफोर लिविंग दैट पर्टिकुलर प्लेस. ओके, सो द प्रायर एक्शन ही हियर टेकन इज the shelter, and that shelter might be strong enough to deal with that disaster. So the measures that will be taken prior to the disaster in order to minimize the impact of that disaster, that is called mitigation, sometimes referred to as structural or non-structural measures. Mitigation could be structural or non-structural measures. Okay, see here also they have given an example. He this all things we will see further when we will see about each and every type of disaster, that how they are going to deal with this particular disaster using structural measures and even non-structural measures. If the training is given to the people of how to deal with the disaster, okay, capacity development is done, then that is called the non-structural. Or if such shelter or an earthquake prone area is constructed, earthquake resistant structure is constructed, that is called the structural measures to reduce the impact of that disaster. Then preparedness. So there is difference between mitigation and preparedness. So what is preparedness? Measures taken in anticipation of a disaster to ensure that appropriate and effective actions are taken in the aftermath. Now, I just told you this, that the shelter could not be made immediately. He is aware that that particular area is prone to such type of disaster. So prior, he will take some measures in order to reduce the impact of the disaster. Prior, the shelter will be made. Even if the disaster occurs or not, he know he is safe. He's safe in the sense he will be having less impact of that disaster. So that is called mitigation. But what is preparedness? Measures taken in anticipation of a disaster to ensure that appropriate and effective actions are taken in the aftermath. Now, he sees a stone is rolling, or a person tells him, watch out, the rock is falling. So he will move from that place immediately so that he will not be affected. That is called preparedness. For example, if I'm living in a coastal area, say I know that my particular area is prone to cyclone. Okay, but this mitigation measures I have not followed. Same, what mitigation measure could be followed in that particular coastal area? Say if it's a higher, if I am building my house at a higher level to what the water floods, उसे higher level पे अगर मैंने already मेरा घर बनाया है, okay? So that is called mitigation measure. I don't have to move from my house even if that particular disaster occurs, even if the cyclone, the flooding happens in that area, because my house is at a higher level, so it won't get affected. But See, my house is not at a higher level. It's a normal house, and it might get affected if there is disaster. So if it's an early warning sign that the cyclone has come in that particular area and it is going to affect my area, what I will do is I will immediately take actions. I will immediately move from that place. First of all, whatever the property that is lying down, I will make sure that it is not affected. I will move it some upstairs and I will leave that place. I will go to my relative's house or some other place, but I won't stay at that house for that particular moment when the cyclone is going to affect that area. So that is called the preparedness. So this is a slight difference between mitigation and preparedness. Okay, so preparedness is measures taken in anticipation of a disaster to ensure that appropriate and effective actions are taken in the aftermath after the disaster has happened. So here the difference is given. See, mitigation and prevention. So what is mitigation? As we told you previously, measures taken prior to the impact of a disaster. Prior, okay, very prior. To minimize its effect, sometimes referred to as structural or non-structural measures. Okay. And prevention. Now, prevention is completely different. You saw that stone was how it was attached to a string and was not allowed to roll down. So, that is measures to avert, to prevent a disaster from occurring if possible. Okay. That is to impede a hazard so that it does not have any harmful effect. That is called prevention. Okay, then to avoiding the hazard to become a disaster. Okay, and since mitigations we have seen prior the measures that are taken, and preparedness measures taken in anticipation of the disaster to ensure that appropriate and effective actions are taken in the aftermath. Okay, that is preparedness. You are prepared to face that disaster because anticipation of the disaster is done. Early warning signs, signals have shown us. So if you are prepared to deal, of course the disaster is going to happen, it is going to affect, but then you are if you are prepared to deal with that particular disaster, that is called the preparedness. Maybe you move out of that particular area, maybe you move your property, maybe you some medical health care are immediately available. So that is called the preparedness. Okay. And immediately there are some structures made by the government where you can move people. So that is called the preparedness. Okay. See, here it is given. The three difference: prevention, mitigation, and preparedness. Okay, so very easily you can understand the difference between these three words. Okay, sorry. Then sand dune fixation. Sand dune in the sense the sand which is formed, say in the coastal area, it is formed because of the wind, because of the water. The sand that is firm in the coastal areas. So sand dune fixation, because the land that is full of that is the sand land. Okay, so sand dune fixation with bushes and trees along with the coastal line as barrier against the surges and the strong wind. So that is also one of the measures taken. Okay, so that because of the erosion, the sand does not get displaced. Okay, so that is why you will provide the bushes, the trees along the coastal line. Okay, and of course, when you provide these bushes and trees along the coastal line, the water coming on the land where people are living, that will be less because much of the water will be prevented by these bushes and the trees to come across the area and go towards the people where people are living. Okay, then where feasible, mangrove forest. Mangrove, the spelling is wrong here. The mangrove forest along the seashore. Now you know the trees and the shrubs that are grown, those are called mangroves, and those mangroves are very important. Okay, and they also help in dealing with this disaster. It's the same thing, the erosion, the water absorption, they help in that. If you have mangroves, you are less affected by a particular cyclone or the particular flooding. Okay, then see here, cyclone shelters in coastal areas or flood shelters along major rivers. See, as I told you, Now, this is a mitigation measure. I know that if at all any cyclone or flooding happens in my area, I am safe because I have made my structure in such a way, okay, that I won't be affected. It's at such a particular height, if you see here. Here, the stairs are provided in order to go to upstairs. But here, even if the water fills, it is not going to damage any property. Okay, so I can live in my own house even if such such particular cyclone event happens. Of course, it is not going to happen frequently. Cyclone in a particular does not happen frequently. Once when it occurs, I don't have to get affected by it. So that is the mitigation measure. Okay, very prior the measures are taken in order to reduce the impact of that disaster. Mock drill on emergency first aid or emergency first aid. Then early warning, international and national and on a community level. See, now you know the hazard is happening and it is going whenever. So you cannot control the cyclone movement. Of course, you cannot control. It is natural. So the disaster is going to happen. Only thing that we have in our hand is to deal with that disaster. So either the mitigation measures would be taken prior or preparedness, immediate preparedness has to be done to deal with the disaster. What is the difference between disaster management and disaster risk management? Very slight difference. Disaster management and disaster risk management. Okay. See, disaster management is a collective term encompassing all the aspects of planning for preparing and responding to disasters. It refers to the management of consequences of disaster. Okay, what is disaster management? That whatever the consequences of the disaster would be, for a particular disaster, the consequences would be, general we would say that it will be loss of life, property, but then specifically the consequences would be different. Okay, what happened during the earthquake will not happen similar during the flood. Okay, there might be specifically difference between the consequences. So management of those consequences, okay, that is called the disaster management. Okay, that is, you know that after disaster, what all things to be done, that comes under disaster management. But what is disaster risk management? Prior risk, you know that this particular area is under a risky area of facing this disaster. So is risk ko hi manage kaise kare? Disaster ho jane ke baad disaster management to hoga hi, but prior to that, how you should manage the risk, that is called the disaster risk management. Samjha? Now, if there is any flooding here, when there is heavy rainfall and flooding happens, so the steps that would be taken to deal with that flood, that will be disaster management. Okay. But now if the government start taking steps from here on for the further years, as we know, our area is risky. When it is monsoon, so the steps that will be planned, the preparedness that will be done prior to 1 year, so that is called the disaster risk management. Okay, so a broad range of activities designed to prevent the loss of lives. Prevent hi karna hai. Aise nahi loss of life ho raha hai and then you are providing some medical aid and the health and grant. That is not the thing. That is comes under the disaster management. Risk management kya? Prevent hi karna hai from the loss of life. Minimize the human suffering. Inform the public and authorities at risk. Minimize the property damage and economic loss. Speed up the recovery process. So risk, when it is at risk, the activities that will be planned, not after the disaster happened, the activities that will be planned in order to deal with the risk of that disaster, that is called the disaster risk management. Okay. So, jaise humne disaster management cycle dekha, response, rehabilitation, reconstruction, development, prevention, mitigation, preparedness, all these terms, terminologies we have seen now. रिस्पॉन्स स्लैश रिलीफ था यहाँ पे, इट्स कम अंडर वन स्टेप ओनली एज आई टोल्ड यू, सिमिलर टाइप मीनिंग. ओके, सो ऑल दिस टर्मिनोलॉजीज वी हैव सीन वन बाय वन. सो दिस इज द डिजास्टर मैनेजमेंट साइकिल, एंड हियर यू सी डिजास्टर रिस्क मैनेजमेंट. यू सी हियर डिजास्टर रिस्क मैनेजमेंट. सो वॉट इज द डिफरेंस हियर? Of course, when the disaster happens, emergency response, rehabilitation, reconstruction. Okay, reconstruction. So till this, the steps are same. That is managing the disaster. But then, after reconstruction, when the community has come to its normal living, okay, then what is to be done? Risk assessment. Risk assessment has to be done. Now this particular area, how, why this particular area was affected by flood? Why? Say when you talk about our own Vasai area where there was not flooding before. Okay, it has started flooding from last few years. Okay, so risk assessment is to be done. That, oh, so Vasai could be flooded. So which all the nearby area that could be flooded in further year? What are the elements that will be at risk? Like we seen, you'll have to do a survey that which area, which elements, which people, which community will be affected. So that is risk assessment. And then the prevention and mitigation measures. And then awareness and capacity building, education, providing education, providing awareness, giving training to people, preparedness, and early warning. So you see these three terms, that is early warning, awareness and capacity building, and risk assessment. These three terms are new in this disaster risk management cycle. Of course, it is the same cycle, but before dealing with the disaster, how we could deal with the risk of that disaster and what steps could be taken in order to deal with the risk of that disaster. Okay, so that is risk assessment, awareness and capacity building, and early warning. Okay, of course, after disaster has happened, emergency response, rehabilitation, everything will be done. But if you have an early warning before the disaster occurred, if you have an early warning that there will be a flooding or there will be a cyclone, people will not go out. Correct? Effect on the people. Of course, the disaster is going to happen, but the effect that will be caused will be reduced. So that is why early warning is also very important. Before the disaster occurred, only the risk of the disaster is there. The cyclone did not come to Mumbai, but there was a risk of it coming to Mumbai, correct? And depending on that risk, we did not move out of our house. So that comes under disaster risk management, okay? So what all things we had seen in this lecture, in this PPT, is the clear-cut distinction between the different terminologies, okay, and difference between the preparedness, mitigation, prevention. I have shown you with the very easy diagram, right? And recovery, rehabilitation, reconstruction, the three R's and the difference. Okay, now as I told you here, it should also come the response and relief, because I told you the recovery is the combination of response, rehabilitation and reconstruction. Inko milake what you call is the recovery phase. Okay, and the difference between disaster management and disaster risk management. Okay, so I hope this particular PPT or the particular lecture has sharpened your knowledge of the different terminologies, and this terminologies will be used from here on throughout the syllabus. Okay, so there has to be no confusion between the different terminologies. Very easily it is explained with the small images, small examples. Okay, so here we will conclude our today's lecture.